Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube. And this morning, like we typically do, we're going to talk a little golf. We're going to talk some travel. I'm actually going to be traveling some, so I'll be reporting on that for you next week as well. And of course, we've got some incredible deals for you, some travel news. You won't want to miss any of it. And joining me this morning, like we always have here in the studio, is Mike McGann. It's good to see you, Mike.
It's good to see you, Dan. How are you, my friend?
I am doing great. How about yourself?
I am relatively outstanding as always, sir.
I'm just loving this beautiful weather.
Oh, it's got, that's part of the reason I'm doing as well as I am.
It is the best time of year. I had the top down in my car, you know, getting a little sun, a little vitamin D, hesitant to leave town. Like I said, I'm heading out west, and I think the weather will be okay out there too. Be heading to California and Las Vegas, and
wow, that's an awesome, just that's enough right there.
Yeah, not bad. Someone's got to do it, may as well be me. And I don't think they're expecting any rain, and I think it's supposed to be beautiful like here, but maybe a tiny bit chillier in the daytime and a lot chillier in the evening, but beautiful nonetheless. So I'm looking forward to it, and of course I'll fill you all in on what I'm up to and what I'm doing, and in either a little while or next week. But first, let's recap a little bit of golf. And I didn't talk too much about it last week because it really wasn't all that exciting. And that was the match between Brooks Koepka and Bryson DeChambeau. And I kind of thought DeChambeau would win, but I was wrong. Koepka won. Koepka had been playing a little bit more, not very well. DeChambeau hadn't been playing much at all, and
right,
he was rusty. The fact that they kind of made up with each other when they played the Ryder Cup, it seems that that was all for show. They seem to actually hate each other, and which is okay, and I think it's just the large personalities and egos that the two of them have make it impossible for them to truly get along.
You can't really coexist like that. I mean, it's I remember watching a movie in the 80s. It was called The Day After. And there was a great line in it, though, talking about America and Russia.
Sounds like a song. Wasn't there a song like that, too?
Oh, The Morning. Yeah.
The Morning
After. This was about nuclear war.
Yeah, there you go.
The guy said, he was talking about Russia and the U.S., and he says, it's like the two biggest kids in the neighborhood.
Yeah.
Sooner or later, they're going to fight.
Exactly. Yeah. No, no doubt. And that's what was going on. But besides the fact that Koepka made short work of it, there was one tidbit of information that came out that is probably really good for our listeners and our radio station here. In some of the chatter, it was revealed that the beverage cart,
okay,
the origin of it actually dates back to Las Vegas.
Why am I not surprised?
And Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin.
Oh, that's so cool. I didn't know that.
Neither did I. And they used to play golf quite a bit out there in Vegas, and they enjoyed it. But unfortunately, they could not be 4 or 5 hours without their favorite alcoholic beverages.
I get that.
So they demanded that there be a beverage cart to take care of them out there on the golf cart. And we can all thank them for it, because obviously now there are beverage carts on every golf course, and we all enjoy a nice cold beverage of some sorts while we're out there playing, especially in the heat of the desert or Florida. So thank you, Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin. By the way, I don't know if you saw it, but on TBS I had noticed this past week also that there was a Christmas special with the two of them that was quite fascinating too. So
I didn't see that, but I had heard it mentioned that it was apparently very good.
You know, I don't remember seeing it when it first aired. I believe it was in black and white, so it was pretty old, obviously, and it had both of their families, all of their kids, also singing with them, and just watching their antics and listening to their music, just great. So if any, these things rerun constantly. It's a holiday special. Obviously, we got a few weeks before Christmas, so check out PBS and watch that. Our listeners will love it.
That sounds really cool.
Also, last week, sometimes we cover other tours, not too often, but there was an event in South Africa. Local golfer Thurston Lawrence won the Joburg Open in Johannesburg. But it was only after 36 holes. They canceled the second two rounds due to the new outbreak of COVID.
Yeah.
And to make matters worse, I didn't catch his name, but one of the golfers couldn't get out of the country to head back to his home in the UK, and he needed to because he was getting married. So I don't know how that turned out. So COVID is still wreaking havoc in the golf world and the travel world, and we'll talk more about it. Also, this past week, a snippet came out of local resident Tiger Woods because, of course, finishing up later today is his event in the Bahamas. So he had to face the cameras and the microphones and field some tough questions about his future in golf and his accident that caused his issues. And when it came to the accident, he refused to say anything. He said the police records say it all. I know people on the inside. I can't mention too much information, but let's just say that especially around the holidays and any time, do not speed. Do not get behind the wheel if you are not sober, whether it's alcohol or any drugs, legal, prescription, or otherwise. Not a good idea. And because of the mistakes that he made and fortunately didn't pay the price legally, medically and career-wise, obviously he will pay the price the rest of his life. He did announce that he does not believe he will ever contend at a major again. He may play in the Masters. He'll get invited, and he may play it occasionally here and there, but he does not believe that he has the ability to play at the same level as before. He's happy he didn't lose his leg. He's happy he could play with his kids. And speaking of which, the PNC Championship is just around the corner.
Right.
Used to be known as the father-son. 2 years ago, his son, while not winning, stole all of the glory for playing so well as a little kid.
I remember that. That was really something.
So they're holding a space open for him with the hope that this might be one of those odds and end kind of tournaments that he's going to try and play in and continue to play, even if he can't win or even if he can't win a major. He believes that his game may be good enough to play a little here and there.
Keeps the presence going. I mean, he's Tiger.
He compared himself to Ben Hogan. Ben Hogan had a horrific car accident and did come back afterwards, but did the same kind of thing, kind of picked and choose where he could play. All right, we have a little more golf news, but I hear our music, so we'll kind of pick it up after the break and finish up on golf. Then we'll move into some travel news and some incredible deals. You won't want to miss any of it. So stay tuned. We'll be right back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Walked into the pro shop, gave my partner a high five. Stepped up on the first tee.
Are you tired of searching for the job you need with the flexibility you want? Whether you're looking for a temporary or permanent position, you need to call Labor Finders. We're already in your community putting people back to work every day. Select from hundreds of daily job listings with companies who are hiring all over the country. With nearly 200 offices nationwide, Labor Finders has temporary and temporary to hire employment opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, and general labor positions, such as electricians, landscapers, flaggers, hospitality, and more. Connect with a personal job agent today to navigate your next career step by calling your local Labor Finders office or by visiting laborfinders.com.
4 Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
Whack down. And we are back, and as we mentioned, a tiny bit more of golf news to cover for you. We've been talking about that new tour that Greg Norman is heading up with Saudi money.
Yes.
The first casualty might be the European Ryder Cup team, because Lee Westwood, who rumor had it might have been the captain, has decided to not take that position, probably because he has been heavily recruited to play on this Saudi tour.
Yep.
And if he decides to take that money, and he's even said that at his age and with the kind of income that he's made for the past 10 years or so playing golf, not that much, that this could be a huge windfall for him, something that might be not possible to say no to. So it seems that he may be the first one. Other folks that are on the European team perhaps, or might be considered for the captaincy of the European team right now, are Luke Donald, Graham McDowell, or Henrik Stenson. So We'll wait to hear about that, but that's perhaps the first casualty of this new tour. Speaking of captains and European teams, the LPGA, the women, the Solheim Cup, they just announced the European captain for 2023 as Suzanne Pedersen. So congratulations to her.
Congratulations, Suzanne.
Yes, she has won it in the past as well. So she's got the experience. Here's an interesting story. We always like these interesting stories. So these two brothers are out playing golf together out in the Northwest, I believe this was. And one guy, he's 85 years old, and he's playing with his 77-year-old brother. This is in Utah.
Okay.
And I guess it was maybe like the 17th hole or so. The younger brother passes out. And the older brother realizes it was a heart attack he was having.
Wow. Having,
and gave him CPR. The first time he had to use it since he was like a teenager or something. And saved his brother's life.
Wow.
He thought he was gone. Didn't what think he would make it, but got to the hospital. And because of the CPR, saved his life. So, yeah, he had said that the last time, it was 50 years previously that
50 years.
He used CPR. And he remembered how to do it and saved his own brother's life. So, crazy story, but happy ending.
You just don't know.
Yes, not as happy a ending, unfortunately. Condolences for the family of Lee Elder, who passed away this past week at the age of 87.
Yeah.
He was the first black golfer to play in the Masters, and this past year at the Masters, he was given the honor of one of the honorary starters to hit the ball first. He was on oxygen, wasn't in great shape, but obviously they realized he didn't have much time, and at least before it was too late, they gave him the honor that he deserved. People in the golf world have all said not only was he someone who broke racial barriers, but just the nicest guy. So, you know, condolences to his family, and he'll be missed.
That's something. But really, it's wonderful that he was able to get that honor on the way out. Definitely well-deserved.
And you know, let's face it, there's a long history at Augusta of not always being fair to everybody.
You're right.
And
that's a good step.
Right. You can't fix the past, but you can certainly change the future.
And yeah, you can at least begin to correct those wrongs.
Exactly.
And I think that honor is a proper way to do it.
Absolutely.
Good.
All right, let's change gears. So I had mentioned that this week I will be spending some time in my second home of Lost Wages. fortunately for me, I usually do pretty well. So I like to say that I'm just going up there to pick up some money and bring it back home.
Gotcha.
But there's a lot of news, a lot of stuff going on out there. And the other gamblers out there are doing a really good job in supporting the casinos because it seems that for the last 7 months, they have broken a record of earning over $1 billion for each month for seven consecutive months. So the last time that they had, I believe the last time they've done it in 8 months has been back in 2006 and 2007.
Wow.
So way pre-pandemic. And keep in mind that the international travelers had not been able to go to Las Vegas until like a week or so ago because they were barred for the past year or two from coming into the country. So I'm in some, you know, groups on social media with people who love Las Vegas and all these international people from Europe in particular who are just, you know, go to Las Vegas every year, twice, three, four times a year,
right,
have been dying to get to Vegas. So they're breaking these records without all those people.
Yeah, that's really impressive.
So the fact that the casinos have hung on just fine and now they have all this pent-up demand from an entire world, it bodes very well for them. So do not run them a benefit. They're doing just fine. And they won't mind it if I take a little bit of their money. Although I have to say, every time I cash in my chips at the table to trade them in for larger, you know, size ones, the pit boss who has to approve it is always shocked that I cash in more than I spent, that I'm ahead.
Every time.
Because every time. So obviously, the vast majority of times when people get up from a table, they do not leave with more than they sat down with. So knock wood. Hopefully the streak continues and I'll relieve them of some of that excess baggage that they need to unload.
I have
unload.
No doubt that you will be the necessary steam valve for a bit of that cash.
And one of the places that I've stayed and played successfully at on many occasions has a glorious history. Later this month, they will be celebrating their 75th anniversary of being the first strip casino. And I'm talking about the Flamingo. Started by Bugsy Siegel and Meyer Lansky.
That's it.
Obviously, you know, people like Sinatra and Martin and all the other Rat Packers and mobsters and whatever spent many a day there, many a night, of course, and they may not even have remembered most of it.
I was going to say, well, at least they have, we'll always remember it with the beverage carts, won't we?
Exactly. There's plenty of beverages in the casino, too.
True story.
I mean, what's the theme here, especially with the people that we love to feature on our radio station here? They do like a drink now and then.
Yeah, that's right.
But then again, musicians,
one
all musicians.
One for my baby and one more for the road and
exactly.
Maybe a third for the casino.
Exactly. So this all kind of ties in. So yeah, and believe it or not, I haven't had a chance, but there are some Rat Pack shows out there, of course, tribute shows to the Rat Packers. So, you know, some of the smaller clubs and stuff, you could actually sit there and listen.
And they're fun.
To
like,
all
I've
that
seen
stuff.
A few of those shows, and there's some really great talent that does
there,
those
there really is. And, you know, the originals aren't here any longer, so this is all we got.
Right.
Also in Las Vegas news, the World Series of Poker, okay, the 53rd annual one will be taking place this summer. And Vince Vaughn will be the celebrity master of ceremonies, but it used to be held at the Rio. Caesar sold the Rio back in 2019, and they just announced that they will be moving it to the Paris and Bally's
okay.
Coming up this year. So that's a big change for you poker fans. And I will be spending a lot of time in Paris, the Paris, and Bally's. So I'll check out the scene and make sure it's okay for all those gamblers.
Keep
and
us
poker
posted,
players.
Dan.
I will. Speaking of which, I guess we still have a minute or two before the break, so I can maybe tease a deal or two before we cut out for the break. So here is a place that is, I know it's on your bucket list because we've spoken about it before.
Okay.
It's someplace that you've been dying to go to. We are talking about Machu Picchu in
Peru. As soon
Peru.
As you said, I'm like, I know where that is.
Okay, and I know while the radio station, you know, they understand your talent and they pay you very, very well for the work you do. But you and everybody else would love to get a really good deal to go to a place like Peru and Machu Picchu,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I would love that.
So a vendor that I found on Travelzoo called Exotica, we talk about their deals
yeah.
very often.
Yes.
They have a deal where you could cover like all of Peru, including Machu Picchu, for less than $100 a night. $699
no way.
Total, okay? Leaving from either Miami or Orlando. And you are going to get, you know, everything included. Round-trip airfare from U.S. to Lima. Flights within Peru, because you're covering so much of the country, you're going to have actually other flights inside the country. 7 nights in well-reviewed hotels. Daily breakfast, guided tours, entry fees, all-ground transportation, airport transfers, and a train journey from the Sacred Valley.
Amazing.
All starting at $699 per person. I don't even know what to say.
How do you get that?
I mean, I've had other deals for $400 more than this, thinking that those were amazing
deals.
Best deals
ever. But that's wild.
I mean,
I got to look at my calendar.
Really? I mean, yeah. For all you children listening, take your allowance money and take your parents to Peru because you can afford it.
Wow, that's kind of beautifully
price.
Put. You're right.
It's just
sell
great.
Some of your old sneakers on eBay. You're good to go.
Exactly. Just crazy. So travelzoo.com is where I found that. You do have to hurry, though. This needs to be booked by December 9th, so you don't have a lot of time. All right. I think it's time for a quick break. I got a whole bunch more deals for you. You won't want to miss it, so stay tuned. We'll be right back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
I owe my soul to the Country Club Pro.
Do you have a project with an upcoming deadline but don't have the manpower to finish on time? Or maybe your business just took on a new client and has a sudden demand for qualified professional workers. Whatever your business needs, Labor Finders has got you covered. Gain access to a steady stream of workers who want to work with an agency that always has placements. With over 40 years of experience in the staffing industry, your staffing problem is no problem to our team of experts. Labor Finders covers many services and costs so you can save time and money while getting employees you can count on today. We take pride in setting safety standards. Work with Labor Finders today, the best of staffing winner for 10 consecutive years. From event hosts, chefs, and housekeepers to general laborers, electricians, and landscapers, we have the workers you need. Consult with one of our nearly 200 offices today to see how we can help staff your next big project at laborfinders.com.
Yeah. And we are back. And
is
also,
it me or is this flying by today?
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I can't believe we're already at this part of the show.
It's crazy. Crazy. So much good stuff to talk about. But the last deal found on TravelZoo was like your bucket list.
Yeah.
This next one's closer to my bucket
list. Talk
okay,
to me. Talk
this,
to me.
This one does not include airfare, but you probably can find airfare for $1,000, give or take a couple of hundred or so.
Okay.
It is the other side of the world, so you know that sounds like a lot of money,
yeah,
but it's not. But this is a package to stay at a five-star hotel with a spa and incredible beaches in Bali.
Okay, yeah, I know we've talked about that. I know that Bali's been something you've been really interested
in. So it's this five-star hotel called the Royal Purnama Hotel. And, of course, you know, oceanfront, morning yoga classes, breakfasts are included. And what we're talking about here, though, is for a one-bedroom, this is five nights, okay? And you could take this any time other than one or two small blackout periods until June of 2023. So you could lock it in now.
Wow, you got a lot of time.
And maybe hope that COVID is gone or something, you know, by then. But starting at $679 for five nights, you get a one-bedroom, ocean view, jacuzzi suite.
Okay, that's just nuts.
Okay, it's an upper floor for the best view of the water.
I love it.
A separate living room, yeah. A kitchenette, a private balcony with a day bed, and a jacuzzi.
Okay.
Okay, you also get breakfast every day for two, a cocktail every day for two, round-trip airport transfers, a black sand full body rejuvenation in the spa for two, which is valued at $212. And if you upgrade, one day you get a floating breakfast in your pool.
Oh, I love that.
Okay,
that
so the
fun.
Upgrade to a one. Okay, so now you're not going to get the ocean view because instead you're getting a swimming pool of your own, a private pool with your suite, a one bedroom pool suite. $899 that cost. So it's an extra $120. And remember, this is for two. This isn't for per person
right.
now. So then you get that extra breakfast. And you can also upgrade to a larger pool villa, if you prefer, for $999. It's a freestanding villa the size of my house, 2,300 square feet.
Okay.
Indoor and outdoor dining areas and a full-size private swimming pool. That's $999. That's $200 a night.
$200 a night for that.
Yes.
For all of that.
And all of the other perks all come things. With it. You just don't get the ocean view. I almost think that I personally might take the cheaper one at $679 and get the
ocean view. An ocean view to
it's
me.
It's still a jacuzzi suite with a balcony. I don't need a private swimming pool.
I would spend more time on that balcony.
Exactly. So like I say, even though it's a little expensive and a little long to get there, this may be the nicest hotel that most of us will ever stay in our entire life.
Very likely.
And for the same price as Motel 6.
Well, there you go.
I mean,
we'll keep the light on for you,
exactly.
Along with the black sand and the spa treatments and free breakfast and everything else in the five-star.
Can you imagine that? I don't have a deadline on this as to when you have to do it, but my guess is do it quick because these things can disappear. So again, travelzoo.com, just do a search for Bali and you will find that. Airfare. Tons of great airfare deals. The best thing to do is just go to Google Flights and put in where you're leaving from, where you're going to. Look at it on the month-by-month chart, and you can see which dates have the cheaper fares because these are not every day, of course. How about Philadelphia? From nonstop from Miami, $97 round trip.
Philly from Miami.
Right. If you'd rather go from West Palm, it's $40 more, $137 round trip.
Now that's a killer deal because normally it's
expensive. Not have to make that trip down to Miami. So yes, and West Palm, it's the best airport.
It really is.
Out of,
it's
no
awesome.
Doubt. But it usually is
a lot more expensive.
I would have to say actually it's $30 more. So for $30
more,
it's worth it.
Or more.
Yep,
that's
I recommend
really
that.
Impressive.
Vegas, I just mentioned. Unfortunately, most of these are not necessarily all direct. Some might be, but as little as $189 round trip from Fort Lauderdale, $191 from Miami, $195 from Orlando. All of those are really good to get out to Las Vegas.
Come on.
Los Angeles, where I will also be this week. From Orlando, nonstop round trip, $127. That's $63.50 each way to Los Angeles.
To L.A.
Yes, on a nonstop round trip.
Traveling
flight.
Back in time because you're crossing time zones.
Yeah, and most of these are from January through March. These are good.
That's
Seattle,
it.
Also very far away. Nonstop round trip, not easy to do. From Fort Lauderdale, $177 to Seattle. That's about as far as you could fly and still be in the continental United States.
Under 200.
Yes, for 177, that. Nonstop round trip. And these are major airlines, all of them, Alaska or Delta. How about Europe? France. You know, we a lot of times have deals to Paris, but how about to Nice?
I love Nice.
493 round trip from Miami. Or Paris from Orlando, 472 round trip. That's not bad to France.
That's awesome.
Just go for the food.
I mean, do it.
I mean, the food is incredible. For all you skiers, maybe you want to ski in Switzerland. How about? From Orlando to Zurich this January through March, so peak ski season, round trip, $416. Okay, this is on Iceland Air. So you're going to go through Reykjavik for sure. Oftentimes, you could get a layover and spend a little time in Reykjavik.
I hear that's worthwhile. I've never been there.
It
but
is,
I hear
and I don't know if it's
food.
Still available, but they used to have a package or a program on Iceland Air where if you did a layover, they would hook you up with one of their employees for like a couple of hours, and they would show you around to something that you chose.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, so they would take, if you like going to a nightclub, they'd take you to a nightclub. If
that
you want to shop at a fancy
service.
Yeah. And so you'd get a pilot or a flight attendant or somebody that lives in Reykjavik, and they'll show you their town for a couple of hours, all included, no extra charge. So, not sure if it still exists, but look into it.
That sounds
One
awesome.
Last deal to Casablanca in Morocco. You could go to Rick's place.
Yeah, oh, that would
you play it again, Sam, whatever. So from Miami, nonstop round trip to Casablanca, 478.
I'm sorry, Casablanca.
Yes.
478.
Yeah, I mean, in Morocco, great food, great French food, of course. Huge French influence
that's
in Morocco.
Morocco.
So
Morocco's
French.
A beautiful place.
Yeah, that's what I hear. Been dying to go check it out. Haven't had a chance. Now maybe is the time. All right. If you want to know who our future guests are going to be, go to facebook.com/TheGolfAndTravel Show. Like the page and you'll know what we're up to. And of course, next week we will be back again. I'll recap my trip to Los Angeles and Las Vegas, and we'll have some more deals and news, and you won't want to miss it. So hopefully you'll join us again for another episode of The Golf and Travel Show. In the meantime, hit them straight.
Home, when my thoughts escaping home, when my music's playing home. Where my love lies waiting silently for me. Every day.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Shoup. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.